Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott here to talk to you today about the 8x8 Work mobile app. This video is going to give a brief introduction on the features and functionalities of this app. Stay tuned for more videos to come, which will go a little bit more in depth into the individual functions. But in the meantime, we're going to go ahead and get started and taking a look at the messages screen. With the messages screen, we have a couple options that you're looking at. First part is all messages, which is all the messages that are present when you first open up the message section. We have one-on-one messages as well as rooms. So just to double click on this just a little bit, one-on-one messages are messages that you would expect from an individual person. So this could be SMS messages as well as messages within your organization. Rooms is another functionality where you can have a group of individuals within your organization, and then you can get together in like a team environment. So share information, share resources, docs, you name it. So that is messages in a nutshell. We're going to jump over here to the icon at the very bottom. And if you notice here, we have a little message icon. We have a phone. We have some dots here in the middle. A little person, which is the address book, and a little video at the end, which is for meetings. So pushing any one of these areas here takes you to the next function within the app. And now clicking on the phone, we're in the call section. So as you would expect, this is where you would make and receive phone calls. So from this screen, we can see that there's all calls, tapping here towards the top, any missed calls, voicemails, and recordings. Going back here to the all call section, and we'll just give you a little preview here, clicking this I for informational button here, and you can see the details of this particular call, when it took place, and any information that you have on the person itself. So we'll go back here, going down towards the bottom, we're gonna click these little dots, and this is where you would actually make that phone call. So if you're familiar with dialing a number, this is where you go to do that. Click in the next section at the very bottom. This is for your contacts. So any contacts you have saved or favorite in this section is what you will find here. I don't have any favorite contacts, and it's not to say that I don't have any favorite people, but I just haven't had it set up in this part of the app. If I click on the company tab towards the top, there's some individual information about the users that are within my organization. And then if you click on the My Contacts, that actually goes into the personal address book for your cell phone. And then you can make calls to those contacts without having to exit the app and then dial that person individually. And then finally, we have meetings. So this is where you would do a video meeting, an audio meeting, and join it in those types of sessions. So this all can be started from the app. I've done another video where you can start it from the desktop app, but it's nice and handy to be able to do it directly from the mobile app. Going up here, I'm going to click on this profile, and then you'll see here some profile information about your contact information. So things like caller ID, whether or not I want to mute notifications. I can set business hours, so that can be helpful if you want to be reached during certain times of the day, as well as individual settings for the device itself. And what I always find helpful too, because this app's always being updated, is a section for what's new. So I can click on that and it tells me exactly what's going on with this current release for 8x8 Work for mobile. I'll click done there, and you see at the very, very bottom, you can log out. So let's just say for whatever reason, you need to log into this app as a different user. You can click that log out button, and then you'll enter in your credentials at that point in time to log in and then take on the identity of that individual. So that is it for the app. And you saw all the functions dealing with messages, calls, contacts, and meetings. Super easy to use. check out the videos that will come. I'm gonna go in more in-depth detail into each of these functions. I hope you found this video helpful. And if you have any questions, comments, or anything that you want to share, please drop them in the comments. I appreciate you for taking a look at this. And then until next time, we'll talk again soon.